For Complex News, I'm Hanuman Welch, and let me get this out of the way now. You're going to be disappointed by how Game of Thrones concludes. And this isn't just speculative, I wanted X to happen, but Y happened instead. I think that everyone is going to be disappointed by how this all wraps up, because Thrones has basically devolved into fan fiction with a heavy dose of lazy writing, coming from two dudes who've already lined up a deal with Disney for the next Star Wars picture, and have some of the worst case of senioritis television has ever seen. And for what it's worth, fans of prestige television are always disappointed when their favorite series come to an end. The Sopranos, Mad Men, Breaking Bad, and most egregiously Lost all managed to disappoint in some degree. But as we head into the series finale of Game of Thrones, I can't help but feeling that all of this just feels so goddamn rushed and unearned. Now, before we get into some of the more heinous examples of lazy writing that we've all had to endure over the last 7 weeks, here's an interview with George R.R. Martin where he explains that at the very beginning of his deal, he assumed that there was enough material in the books to date for 10 to 11 years of show series. But showrunners David Benioff and D.B. Weiss insisted on only 7 and had to be persuaded, sometimes around season 5 or 6, to go as long as 8.
David and Dan have been saying for, like 5 years that 7 seasons was all they would go. And we got them to go to 8, but not any more than that.
George clearly thinking there was more narrative meat on that bone to go past 8 seasons. But in season 6, Benioff and Weiss cut their HBO deal and proceeded to jam the overarching story into the last 2 truncated seasons, leaving crucial consistency and character development on the cutting room floor, and Martin cut his deal for the prequels. They got their check and started planning their next project 4 years ago and sort of crammed together these last 2 seasons before shopping for a third beach house or whatever it is that rich people do. And what better place to start this than this mission following episode 4 and the death of Rhaegal? I guess just one of the most keen strategic minds that conquered Essos and Meereen, unified the Dothraki, and sailed her army across the Narrow Sea just plumb and forgot how boats work. You know what you kind of forget about? Flossing, taking your vitamins, charging your phone before you go to sleep. Those are things you forget about. Not a fleet of warships that you literally pointed to on your big map 1 episode prior. So let's start with Dany. Spoilers ahead if you aren't caught up on episode 7. Daenerys Targaryen went true and full final solution on the citizens of King's Landing and unleashed hell from the sky, vaporizing any shred of goodwill alongside most of the women and children of the Westerosi capital. Dany had a clear win over Cersei and decided to ignore the bells of surrender, fully giving in to her Targaryen nature and going 100% Mad Queen. Now, if this felt abrupt to the point of feeling like you've missed an episode somewhere along the way, you are not alone. We've spent 8 seasons cheering for a character that had been assured would overcome her Targaryen nature. Sure, there have been frustrations and betrayal for as long as Dany has been in power, and especially since she's elevated Tyrion to Hand of the Queen and crossed the Narrow Sea. But those subtle foreshadowings don't seem to track with the abrupt narrative whiplash we're all being forced to endure in this final season. The heel turn to the Mad Queen doesn't seem to track, considering we've followed the Mother of Dragons and Breaker of Chains for as long as we have, with 1 episode left. It just smacks of lazy writing. Suddenly, Dany feels isolated and betrayed yet again. She's perfectly fine with barbecuing hundreds of thousands of people who have already surrendered, and it feels like something that should have been dismissed as hack during the table read. Up next, Jon Snow. Do something. Anything. I mean, it's clear that he's going to become the Queen Slayer, and all those noble intentions and honor are going to go right out the window now that he's witnessed Dany's clumsy turn to Mad Queen. But season 8 has all but sidelined Jon as he wrestles with his lineage, but we are long overdue for him to do anything, something at this point. If it weren't for Arya, Melisandre, Dany, Egret, etc., etc., saving his ass time after time, Jon's honor would have gotten him killed seasons ago. Now all we have left is for him to go full Anakin Skywalker in the last 90 minutes and kill his aunt, lover, slash queen, and rule the 7 kingdoms with the title of Queenslayer, the same way Jaime had to carry around Kingslayer for the entirety of his adult life. And will Arya take advantage of the seemingly second chance given to her by the Hound? Well, if we take Melisandre's words during the Siege of Winterfell, along with her and Arya's season 3 encounter when she saw Arya's future and declared, "I see a darkness in you, and in that darkness, eyes staring back at me. Brown eyes, blue eyes, green eyes, eyes you'll shut forever." Now, we all thought those green eyes would belong to Cersei after Arya off the Night King and Walder Frey, but after Arya wandered the decimation of King's Landing, it seems that Daenerys is the next logical target. I don't think Arya will get 2 major kills of both the Night King and Dany, but there's been no official confirmation of Dany's eye color on the show. But there was a lot of focus on Arya in the Bells, especially as she came to the realization of the destruction Daenerys is capable of. Jaime went out fulfilling his part of Cersei's death prophecy, which, in case you forget, went something like, "When your tears have drowned you, the Valonqar shall wrap his hands about your pale white throat and choke the life from you." Valonqar being High Valyrian for little brother. Now, the two were crushed to death, but not before Jaime knighted and deflowered Brienne of Tarth, leaving behind his last shot at true redemption so he could die crushed to death like a horny dummy for a woman who loved him for what he actually was, behind in Winterfell to return to his sister, whose hobbies include torture and terrorism. Again, we're finally in the realm of fanfic as he gets to die in the arms of his sister, crushed in the crypts of the Red Keep, like it was a page pulled from some teenager's dream journal. The decision to return to King's Landing completely undercuts the moral growth the show has spent entire seasons establishing for Jaime. He earned the right to live, but again, decided to die like a dummy. And speaking of dummies, how is Tyrion now the dumbest one on the show? What was once a fan favorite spouting wisdom and offering counsel at every turn is now one of the most ineffectual characters that's managed to limp to the finale. Ratting out his best friend Varys in some misplaced sense of loyalty to Dany, and Varys letting himself get roasted alive to prove that Dany is unfit to rule is poetic, but not the actions of Tyrion, a character who managed to survive this long on his wits alone. Which left us with just this shot of Tyrion realizing just how badly he's managed to get to bed. When the series departed from the books, Benioff and Weiss were faced with taking over a character who was witty, brilliant, and canny in the pages of Martin's work, and reducing him to a self-doubting sap drained of any of his previous edge. From the death of Cersei to Dany's heel turn to villain, most of these loose ends were wrapped up very quickly and none of it felt earned. Heading into the series finale, I keep getting the distinct impression that all of the important character development is happening off-screen. And that's more the result of 10 pounds of hasty writing being crammed into a 5-pound bag. With the final episode upon us, we're clearly going to get Jon Snow, a man who has never been the smartest character on the show, likely kill Dany if Arya doesn't beat him to it. What are your thoughts on the final season of Game of Thrones? Let us know what you think in the comments below, and for everything else, subscribe to Complex on YouTube. For Complex News, I'm Hanuman Welch.